Are you sick and tired of gambling your hard-earned money on Madden packs? Well, look no further than my sponsor, MMOEXP, for the cheapest and the most reliable MUG coins on the market. And don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 5% off. The link for their website will be right at the top of the description. What's going on, guys? For the third and final golden ticket gameplay of the day, we are looking at the brand new Benny Snell. Before we hop into it, though, if you are new here, hit that subscribe button. We are on the road to 30,000 subscribers with the subscribe button for notifications. We post daily Madden 21 content. And also, do not forget to hit that like button. I will leave a link for my Twitch channel down in the description. I will be live tonight over on Twitch rating teams live, so if you want a chance to have your own team rated, all you have to do is come through to the stream tonight. And the DK Metcalf video is actually not out yet, so shout out to whoever this absolute legend is right here for commenting the emoji on the last video. So here is the golden ticket Benny Snell. He's got 98 speed with 99 acceleration, 94 agility, 99 carrying, 84 catching with a 93 COD, 99 trucking, and a 99 break tackle. The card is 5'10", 224 pounds, 88 strength, and yep, has the 98 speed, 99 acceleration. So yes, cannot get to 99-99 on no theme team, but elusive back archetype, and today we're rocking with full play fake and full sprinter on Benny Snell. So looking at Benny Snell's stats, I'm a big fan of, you know, his break tackle, his trucking, his size, and his weight. But one thing I will say is I don't really value a golden ticket running back nearly as much as I value a golden ticket quarterback or a golden ticket safety or a golden ticket user. I don't really value a golden ticket running back or really a golden ticket receiver that much either, because most of the time you're not stacking out the abilities and going crazy. So I don't really value a golden ticket running back as much as I really probably should. But if we head down here, he's going to have, yes, the golden ticket running back stats, the 99 trucking, 99 stiff arm, 99 juke, 95 spin, 99 break tackle, 99 carrying as well. Also, yeah, pretty good short route running, 82 with an 84 catching. So, yeah, even though he has those crazy power stats, also, yeah, can catch passes pretty well. But the only problem I have with Benny Snell, and yes, I know I am kind of splitting hairs, is whoever built this card kind of messed up because, yes, they did not give him any receiving back archetype slot. So, yeah, you cannot get the 1 AP backfield master, unfortunately. I know it's very unfortunate. It really is, because yeah, it would have been nice to have it on that card, kind of boost his routing a little bit. Even though he has the crazy power back stats, would have been nice to have, you know, the 1 AP backfield master. But it is what it is. Whoever built this card did, I feel like they did mess up there big time, and they actually gave us more power back slots than elusive slots, which is definitely interesting as well. But here are the abilities that we're rocking with today. We have Reach for it, Bruiser for 2 AP, and Evasive 2 AP. So a 5 AP setup on Benny Snell today. Here what the AP's worth in the power back slot. Here we go. He does get tank as well. No joystick and no leapfrog. So that's the power back slots. In the evasive slots, here's what he gets. Backfield master, 2 AP instead of 1, which would have been nice if we did get a receiving back slot. But here are the elusive slots. Here they are. And yeah, team chems, only Steelers, full play fake, full sprinter, like I said. But yeah, let's hop into it. I actually do like Benny Snell in real life. I always said that Benny Snell is the better back in that backfield. People did disagree with that statement, but I always felt that Benny Snell's kind of underrated. Probably won't get his time in the spotlight this year either, you know, with Najee Harris coming in there. But yeah, definitely excited to use Benny Snell. That's enough talking. Let's hop right into it. All right, here we go. Game number one, and yes, that is the man's name. His name is the Rusty Carrot, and he's coming out here onside kicking. But honestly, with a guy with the name Rusty Carrot, I'd expect something like this to happen. I expect the onside kick from the Rusty Carrot. So we are going to have a short field of play with Benny Snell here. And by the way, yeah, I still have RG3. I'm waiting for Tim Tebow's price to completely drop, and then I'll go ahead and get him. But yeah, I think RG3 is going to get replaced with Tim Tebow. I read the comments on the Tim Tebow game plan. It feels like a lot of you guys agree with me. EA definitely did change that release. That is not the release that Tim Tebow always had. So, yeah, Tim Tebow's got a quick release now with Gunslinger. That's all I'm going to say. And I have him on the Jets team. The card played great after the run, so I'm probably going to replace Timmy T. I'm probably going to replace RG3 with Timmy T. But here we go. First run of the day with Benny Snell. Let's see how he does. Stop, go. There we go. We should be going here on the first run. I'm going to try a little spin move there. And there we go. Benny Snell getting loose. Touchdown the first run. And there's his juke animation. There's the spin. And he's looking good so far. I literally just one carry. I just casually pulled that off. Goes back and Neville. I mean, Neville's just there. Like, that's what Neville's going to do for you, man. And look, and Neville refuses to go down. Oh! Oh, my goodness. You do? I mean, I'm just addicted to it. As we're going to get the ball right back. Thankfully, we got Steve Atwater. Oh. Okay, or don't let me give up on the play. And now let's go right back to Benny Snell. We're not going to be able to. Let's hop into another game. Benny Snell, one carry for 50 yards and a touchdown. But, you know, it's happening another game. Hopefully, Benny can get some more carries in that next game. That is the plan. Here we go. I want to try to get a stiff arm, maybe. Someone told me a new stiff arm strategy, which is just spam it. I don't know if that is what the move is, but someone told me just to spam stiff arm. So I'm going to try that. If it doesn't work today, then I'm just going to stop trying with stiff arms in general. But that is what I was told. Just spam it as hard as you can and just hope for the best. So I'm just going to keep trying to do that. All right. I guess we're just going to keep trying to go stiff arm maybe. Like, why not, right? We have fan out there. Stiff arm. I'm telling you. I mean, that is Cam Chancellor clicked on a user. So that's no slouch out there. But still, man, all I need is just... I mean, still more energy, by the way, but I need one stiff arm, just one of them. I haven't had a stiff arm in so long. That truck we had today in that Tim Tebow gameplay felt amazing. That truck we had, oh my, that was just perfect. But all I need now is a stiff arm to complete the day. Up the middle, cut it back. Okay, all I wanted was a first down there. I wasn't locked in on, you know, trying to make anything too crazy happen. But so far, the COD feels good. I'm not really, no real complaints so far with Benny Snell. I feel like this card might get overlooked because his name is Benny Snell. I guarantee if we got like a... maybe like a Bo Jackson with these same exact stats. I'm sure this card would be a whole lot more hyped up. I'm sure of that. But I mean, this card feels pretty good so far. But also, they'd probably never drop a Bo Jackson with stats like that. But Benny's moving. Benny is moving a little bit, and we should score this. We should score this touchdown, Benny Snell, his second of the day. And yeah, we've broken two pretty big runs with Benny so far today. He's nice, man. He's nice, and he's going for around 300K already. And let's hop into one more game. But yeah, he's already going for a good price. Card might be the move at halfback. Like, why not? I don't see why you wouldn't want that guy on your team. All right, here we go. We got game number 3, and we are facing new All-Star 18. Our first carry of this game ended up being a little 3-yard carry on the Buck Alert. But let's try to go 0-1 trap now up the middle. Good run. 1-on-1, run him over. Or don't, Benny. Okay. It's okay, dude. It's okay. I probably should try hurdling. That's my bad. I want to go with the lay fade here, Robert Woods. Benny's still on the Texas route. I mean, if we can get Benny open, that'd be phenomenal. Benny's going to get open. There we go. We have room. Go, Benny. He's backing up. I tried air trucking, but he does not have the Jerome Bettis air truck capabilities, clearly. But Benny Snell does go down after a nice little catch. Probably gassed. Yep, we can put him in the game right now. So, yes, he was gassed. Let's go ahead and let's try to throw him back in there. All right, so kind of a new formation. Let's go ahead and let's try this again. He's clicked onto the wrong guy, it feels like. Stun in, stun out. There you go, Benny. And that should be another touchdown for Benny Snell. No one even near Benny. I want a stiff arm. Okay, we're not going to get our stiff arm today. It's not looking like. This guy will probably end up leaving us real soon. But Benny Snell, once again, good. I mean, we can show off the pass catching in that game. Definitely could have been a better gain for us. But Benny Snell does end up with a rushing touchdown. There he is holding the bag of money. Someone pay Benny Snell. Someone please pay the man. But I mean, I'm telling you, I like Benny Snell in real life. He has like this, you know, like the little spinny mouth guard. You know what I mean? I'm a fan of Benny, man. Here we go. Might be a run. It could be like a little inside zone. No screen. Watch over the top, over the middle. Probably wants to let Bell underneath. Throws it in. There we go. Hey, my ends can play coverage too. Do not forget about that. I mean, he's not going to animate, obviously. But yeah, my ends do play a little bit of coverage. And can we talk about how ugly EA made Zach Wilson's face scan? Like, he's an attractive dude. Like, can we give him some kind of respect out here? Like, he's not an ugly guy. Like, he's not. Like, why are we doing him dirty? Why are we disrespecting him? Yes, my ends do play coverage. I tell you guys this and you guys don't listen. But yeah, my defensive ends are going to lurk you every once in a while if they have to. All right, here we go. Let's try the Texas route. It can't get open. Obviously, this being a Benny Snell gameplay, we have to hit him. But, I mean, this guy is just giving me charity reception, so I'll take him. And hopefully, we can at least finish this drive with another Benny Snell touchdown. That's at least that's the lowest of expectations I could ask for myself here. So, we should be able to punch this in. I'm going to try a toss play. RG3 still throwing dots, man. But Tim, man, Tim Tebow was something else today, I'm telling you guys. But here we go. Off the edge. Should be able to walk this thing in. And hurdle, maybe? I tried hurdling in, but Benny just... He's just bigger, stronger, and faster for Benny Snell's 4th TD of the day. A very impressive gameplay for my man Benny. Eight carries, 79 yards. Also caught a few passes. And I think, yeah, it was this game, right? He caught the passes. But it's a very impressive debut for my man Benny. All right, guys. So that is going to do it for the Benny Snell gameplay. And this card, obviously, being a golden ticket, the stats are juiced. The card played amazing for us today. He finished those big runs, was breaking tackles, making dudes miss, can catch passes. But like I said earlier, I don't really value a golden ticket halfback as much as I do like a quarterback or a defensive player. So yeah, I'm not going to say that he's the best because just because he's a golden ticket because the abilities don't matter as much as they would like on a quarterback, like I said. So I think Benny Snell's definitely top 5, top 3, debatably somewhere in that range. The card is definitely great. And also going for a really good price right now. This card's going for 300K. So if you have 300K looking for a new halfback, I don't see how Benny Snell would ever play bad for you. I mean, get solid abilities. Obviously, I wish he did get that backfield master for 1 AP. But, you know, it is what it is. Benny's still a very good option. Yes, Benny is getting the seal of approval today without question. This card played great for us. So, yeah, if you are still watching, let's comment the snail emoji. I don't even know if there's a snail emoji. So if there's not a snail emoji, comment a random emoji. I have no idea if there actually is one because, you know, snail, it just feels right. I don't know if there actually is one though. So yeah, comment that down below if you are still watching. And if you are new here, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. We post daily Madden 21 content. And as always, I will see you boys in the next one.